We, as humans, have always been captivated by the mysteries of our existence. In the eerie depths of the cosmos, secrets are hidden within the intricate equations and groundbreaking experiments of quantum optics. Who are we, really? What is the true nature of our universe? Light, a phenomenon we often take for granted, has unveiled answers that are profoundly unsettling, almost as if taken from the pages of Isaac Asimov's most gripping sci-fi story. The photon, the fundamental quantum of light, holds the keys to these enigmatic questions. Today, my friends, you are joining me on a journey through an astounding story that is driving the future of technology and evolution, yet remains tantalizingly elusive in our understanding. But be prepared, as the answers we have uncovered might take your sleep away. Our story initiates almost 120 years ago, when Albert Einstein came up with the photoelectric effect, and photons were marked as particles forever. The photoelectric effect shows light is made of particles. When light shines on a metal, it can knock out electrons. Increasing the brightness or intensity of light doesn't make these electrons move faster or have more kinetic energy, as you would expect from classical wave theory. Instead, only light with a high enough frequency can knock out electrons, showing that light comes in tiny packets called photons, and since then we have been stuck imagining photons as these tiny glimmering balls bouncing around. What happens if we throw these glimmering balls of light, our photons, through two narrow slits? Naturally, one might imagine two distinct bands forming on the screen behind, right? Yet what actually happens is quite surprising. When light is directed toward a double slit, an interference pattern of bright and dark bands emerges instead. This phenomenon puzzled scientists for centuries. To understand this, we need to revisit the pioneering work of Christian Huygens and Thomas Young. Huygens had an interesting idea. He thought that every point of a wave acts like a tiny source of more waves, just like ripples in water. Each ripple can create more ripples spreading out and overlapping. Young's double-slit experiment demonstrated this principle spectacularly, showing that light could produce interference patterns characteristic of waves. When the crest of one wave meets the crest of another, they add up to make a brighter, bigger wave. This is called constructive interference. On the other hand, when the crest of one wave meets the trough of another, they cancel each other out, creating a dark spot. This is called destructive interference. So when light passes through the two slits, it behaves like these ripples, forming bright and dark bands on the screen. This shows that light, while we often think of it as tiny particles called photons, also behaves like waves. But what if we sent just one photon at a time through these slits? Would we still observe the interference pattern? Intuitively, you might think not. It's a localized particle, after all, which means it would choose either one or the other path. A single photon shouldn't interfere with itself, right? Well, not exactly. Even when photons are sent one at a time, over time they build up an interference pattern. Initially, each photon seems to land randomly on a detector screen. Yet, as more photons are sent through, a familiar pattern begins to emerge, a pattern strikingly similar to the one formed by waves. This raises an eerie question. How does each photon know the path the previous photons took? What kind of conspiracy is this? The truth is spine-chilling. The photon is neither purely a particle nor purely a wave. It is something else entirely, something that defies our classical understanding. This enigma lies at the heart of quantum optics and underscores the bizarre yet fascinating nature of reality. Speaking of reality, Einstein was deeply troubled by the ideas emerging from quantum mechanics, especially the uncertainty principle, which made him question, well, everything.
Before we dive into his thoughts, let's talk about one of the most mind-boggling phenomena that quantum mechanics tells us: entanglement. Entanglement is like a mysterious connection between two particles. Imagine you have two magic coins, and if you flip one to heads, the other instantly shows tails, no matter how far apart they are. The strange connection means that measuring one particle's state instantly tells you the state of the other, even if they are light years apart. This idea is strange because it goes against two things that we know of. One, locality. This means that things can only be affected by their immediate surroundings. But with entanglement, it seems like the particles can affect each other instantly, no matter the distance, even if they are universe apart. Number two, reality. This means that things have definite properties whether we look at them or not. But entanglement makes it seem like the particles don't have definite properties until we measure them. Einstein, along with his colleagues Podolsky and Rosen, used this idea to propose what is now known as the EPR paradox. They argued that if quantum mechanics were correct, then either, number one, the quantum description of reality is incomplete, or two, if two physical quantities cannot be measured at the same time, they cannot both be real. In simpler terms, they were saying that if quantum mechanics were true, then the way we think about reality and how things are connected must be wrong. This was Einstein's way of pointing out that he saw as a fundamental problem in quantum theory. Years went by, and scientists kept trying to understand the strange connections predicted by quantum mechanics. John Bell, a physicist, came up with a clever way to test whether particles are truly connected in the spooky way quantum mechanics suggests, or if there is a hidden explanation we haven't found yet. Was Einstein correct about quantum mechanics being wrong? This test is known as Bell's inequality. One of the best ways to test Bell's inequality is the CHSH experiment, named after the scientists Clauser, Horn, Shimoni, and Holt. They wanted to see if the results of measuring entangled particles would match what quantum mechanics predicts. Let's go back to our entangled particles, the twins who feel each other even though they're separated forever. Scientists measure these particles in different ways and look at how their measurements are related. Bell's inequality is given on the screen. If this inequality is proven correct, then quantum mechanics is wrong. But if S is greater than 2, it means the particles are connected in the spooky way quantum mechanics predicts, and there's no hidden explanation. When scientists did these experiments, they found that S was indeed greater than 2. Our usual ideas about how things are connected or locality don't always apply. It was a huge discovery that changed how we think about the universe.
Wait, wasn't there another term that Einstein based his theories of EPR on? Reality. Me, you, us. We exist, right? Well, the fabric of reality was challenged by the GHZ experiment, named after physicists Greenberger, Horn, and Zeilinger. Imagine three particles entangled in such a way that they share a bizarre interconnected fate. Only this time, three of the particles are there. In the GHZ experiment, the particles' states are described by a quantum wave function that looks something like what you see in the screen. This equation represents a superposition where the particles are in a blend of all being in state 0 and all being in state 1 simultaneously. It's like a cosmic coin toss where the outcome isn't decided until you observe it.
Imagine you and your friends each hold a ball that can magically change between two colors, red and blue. You can choose to check the colors in two ways, either a normal look, or X, or a special look, or Y.
Here's what happens. If all three of you use the normal look, the balls always turn out such that one is different. For example, two might be red and one blue. If one of you uses the normal look and the others use the special look, the balls always turn out to be the same color. Now, let's say there was a rule that the balls already decided their colors before you even looked. You would expect certain combinations of red and blue when checking. But when you and your friends try it, the results don't follow those expected rules, showing that the colors aren't set until you actually look. This tells us something mind-bending about reality at the quantum level. What we think of as fixed properties, like the color of a ball, are not actually fixed until we measure them. This challenges our everyday experiences and suggests that some elements of what we consider reality might actually be unreal until observed. So, what does all these mean for us? What about the things we see, touch, and feel? Aren't they real? The answer is both simple and incredibly complex. In our everyday lives, objects seem solid and reliable, but at the tiniest scales, the rules change. Quantum phenomena take over, and the world becomes a place of probabilities and entanglement. Scientists are still figuring out where the transition happens, where the quantum world fades and our familiar reality emerges. It's like waking from a vivid dream to a clear, solid world. But these quantum phenomena are not just abstract concepts. They're leading to groundbreaking applications that are truly shaping our world. Quantum computers can solve complex problems much faster than classical computers can and hold the potential to transform fields like cryptography, medicine, and artificial intelligence. As we continue to explore and understand quantum mechanics, we are unlocking new possibilities that could change the way we live and interact with the world. But this journey also opens up questions that challenge our deepest assumptions. Could it be that our reality is just a sophisticated simulation with quantum mechanics as the underlying code? What if we are incredibly advanced AI systems living in a seemingly real world that is nothing more than a simulation? The true nature of our existence might be far stranger than we can imagine, and who knows what we'll discover next.